Oh guys, all YouTube friends. Well, today is the 9th of February, the day sort of before the 20th anniversary of my dad's death. So it's basically, you know, 20 years has passed and it still doesn't seem like yesterday. I mean, I don't miss him the way my mum that would, because to me, the way I am is that my father is at home with my mum when I'm not there. It's only when I go to my mum's and he's not there, then he sort of head says he's at work, because he would tell you always at work. So I don't sort of miss him the way I obviously think of my mum and I would. But yeah, at the crematorium the day I'm actually with. Don't you wanna learn to deal with fear? Don't you wanna take the wheel and steer? Don't you wait another minute? Me mum, we decided to come up to the crematorium where he was finally laid to rest. We'll show you the plot shortly, but also I thought I'll just show you. So you see, this is my father's one here, and he died at only 48 years of age. Yeah, it's no age at all that to go, and no age at all. Yeah, just 48 years of age. I mean, I'm sort of very fast approaching that age myself. I'm only 2 years off of myself, you know. So I've been told by sort of some of the family members that I'm very much like my dad in a lot of ways, but I also know I'm very much not like him in a lot of other ways as well. My father was a hugely liked bloke, you know. He was very outgoing as well. He could talk to just about anybody. You know, I wish sometimes that I was a bit more like that. I'm a lot more withdrawn, a lot more inward on myself. You know, I'm a lot more introverted than my dad ever was. But he was a great bloke and he was loved by so many people. He was unbelievable. You know, anyone that ever met him just thought he was great. I've got to admit that those that get to know me seem to think that I'm a decent enough guy, which is nice. But it's just not that many people actually get to know me. Sort of very much the type that keeps himself to himself, and very few get inside my little circle of people. Yeah, I don't tend to bother with so many people. I keep myself. I'm a very much a loner, and that's what I've always been. But today, being almost the 20th anniversary of his death, I thought we'd come up here and yeah, basically sort of share the day and spend some time with me mum. So there we go. I'll show you where the plot is, where he was finally at the rest, and we'll show you the views that he's got from up here, you know, because it is an absolutely gorgeous place. This is basically Mount Seth Crematorium, and it's absolutely a gorgeous place. I love coming here. So there's the actual place itself, where you actually sort of get cremated and what have you. Where we were before, where I was speaking to you before, was in the actual sort of little remembrance chapel, place where they put everybody's name into the book and what have you. I mean, what you can see is basically idyllic sort of place. I'll show you more when we get closer to where my dad was put, but I mean, you can see here you just got acres and acres of land all the way around, and most of it hasn't been interrupted by housing and stuff like that, you know. So it's beautiful, but I'll show you more as we get further around. So here is basically like the plot area that my father is in. It's like somewhere in amongst this lot of now grass. And that's where his plot was. He was died on the 10th and was cremated on the 14th. On Valentine's Day, which also coincides to be my eldest daughter's birthday. So it was a bit of a strange one, you know, that was celebrating my eldest daughter's birthday, but it's also the day that my father was cremated. But I mean, you can see here, you know, just how bloody beautiful it is and how sort of serene it is, just hearing some of the birds chatter away. And so
Mum's just been up to lay a flower on her mum and dad's patch. You know, come down to my father's patch to spend a bit of time. And mum's decided to plant a plant. This is what you do with plants. She's decided to plant a plant and represent my father's thingy there, so it's busy doing. I don't think you can make it out at all, but it is actually got a little bit of snow falling now. Well, I've been told that this weekend could be like a Siberian winter for us, so the temperatures could hit bloody well below the minuses. Yeah, I think it could be down as low as bloody minus 15 and that this weekend. This is an ideal place to come and to contemplate things, you know. Contemplate life. Think about where you are, where you're going, where you've come from, how far you've come in life. It's a place I used to come regularly when he first died, just to speak to him, to try and sort out my own issues. Even though I wasn't getting any answers from him, obviously, but it was just a good place to come and chat with him and let him know what was happening in my life at the time. And then probably a few years ago I just really stopped being and just come down every now and again and just touch up and I don't know whether what I believe in it now. I certainly don't believe in a God anymore. I stopped that when my dad did die. Because I just felt, well, yeah, how can there be a God up there watching over what all if he's willing to take someone like my father away? You know, and he didn't deserve it. He's a guy that was much loved. Yeah, that's the way it goes. Life.
Snow.
I don't know, so I've just mentioned that, that's snow. Oh, anyway, guys, out gang, this is where it is. So I think it's where I've come to contemplate certain aspects of life and almost look for answers from myself for them. It's a lovely place, I love coming here. It's always bitterly cold, unless you come during the summer months. If you get a nice day, then it'd be lovely. But obviously, with it being February and starting to snow, it's bitterly cold, but it's still absolutely gorgeous place to come. Yes. Idyllic. I decided to come here, it's the Woodman's Arms, for a meal. It's a lovely place again. It's out in the countryside. Yeah, I've been here before many a time. I don't think I've ever recorded anything with me for a long time, so
I don't
know. So I'm out with my mum having a meal at this place, the Woodman's Arms. I do know they have really good meals in here, so I'm looking forward to having this one now. This is in, and I'll show you what it's like when we get in there. This is a place here. It's a beautiful, almost like a Western style feel to the place. See, I've been here a few times before with the family, but never just with me mum alone. It's a greyish, murky day, maybe a little bit of snowfall every now and again, because hopefully it hasn't laid all, so. But here we go. It's a lovely place. Let's see, I'm going to have myself a meal with me. I'll show you what it is when it gets here. I'm not worried about the macros, which is different to me.
No.
So, I don't have to worry so much with the macros we all have had this morning. There's some protein porridge, and I will be going training later on this afternoon, so I don't have to worry so much with the macros in a minute. And it will fit within the macros for the day, so it's not like I'm going to sort of go well over the top, you know. It's still going to be within the macros that I have for the day, so I'm not even worried with it all. And like I say, you're not going to ruin anything by sort of the odd little cheat meal here and there. I still have this month's cheat meal to go with my family. And obviously I'll take this out on that one as well when I do that one, but for now I'll show you what I get when it arrives. Okay guys, there it is guys, a bit of chicken topped with some bacon and cheese, little fries, onion rings and some garden peas. That's what we're having. Everyone's having the same thing, so there we go, that's what we're gonna have. And that's what I'm going to tuck into and enjoy.
Tonight.
So, let's get dug into this thing. There you go guys, I've just dropped my mum off. Spent a good few hours with my mum in the day. With it being almost the anniversary, because obviously I'm at work tomorrow, so it's not like I could spend the day with her tomorrow on the actual day. But, you know, 20 years have passed. 20 years have passed, and it's been like a blink of my eye. You know, so all these youngs out there, or even older ones out there, that think, you know, life goes so freaking slowly and so thing. No, it doesn't. Yeah, it goes by in a blink of an eye. It really does. And it's gotta make you think, you know. A lot of times it does affect me in a way to think, you know, I'm only 2 years off of the age that my father died at. You know, he didn't reach 50. Yeah. So you wonder why, like, sometimes I'll find drive from that. Yeah, that's where sometimes I'll find the drive from to keep us going. You know, this channel is what truly keeps us on the path of trying to get into the best shape of my life, because I would have quit well before now if I wasn't doing this channel and wanting to show that it can be done for all these other people out there that may need that thing to say, you know, I'm in a shit state. How am I going to get to feeling better, to looking better, to being better, to being a better version of yourself? You guys keep me good. Yeah. I know there ain't that many people watching it just yet. It is creeping up, and I am absolutely delighted with that. It's great news. But knowing that I have a reason to do it helps to keep us going. Yeah. I've also got the thing, like, saying, like, of knowing that I'm 2 years off what age my dad was when he died. And that gives us that little bit more thing to sort of say, you know what it is? I need to turn my life around. I need to make a little bit better of it than what I have been. Yeah, because there is no other opportunities. There is no other time. Yeah, I'm still doing a lot of stuff and still living a life that isn't great, that isn't as fulfilling as it could be. But also, I do have the reality there that I do have a mortgage. I do have a family to take care of. You know, you'll get a lot of these youngins that are living the fitness lifestyle, that are always going on about living a dream, doing it, just go for it, and back down. When you are young and you have no other responsibilities, that's all well and good, and that is great. And go for it 100%. No doubt. I would even say that. When it becomes different, even just slightly different, is when you have those other responsibilities. You know, when you have kids, when you have a mortgage and stuff like that to pay for, it becomes a little bit different. I'm not saying give up on your dreams if that's what you get. No, I haven't given up on my dreams totally. I am trying to take those steps towards them now a bit more. But I also have to realise that I can't just do what I want to do and how I want to do it, the way I want to do it, because I have to take into account how it's going to affect my family, how it's going to affect my kids. Is it going to have an effect on whether I can afford to pay the damn mortgage that month? You know, I can't just sit aside. You know, I don't like my job. It's getting to the point where it's stressful as hell for us at the minute. I'm really hating getting up every morning going to work. So let's just fucking quit it and get on to something else. Nah, I can't do that, because then I wouldn't be able to pay the freaking mortgage. I wouldn't be able to pay to go training. I wouldn't be able to pay to have the stuff that I need to grow, to get stronger, to get fitter, to get leaner, to look better. Yeah. So I have to bite the bullet and keep on doing this until something else comes along, till another door opens that allows me to change my life around. You know, I would love nothing better than to quit my job. Even I used to love my job, didn't get me wrong, I did used to love it. But I'm going through so much stress there at the minute, it's just unbelievable. Yeah. And I can't really talk about it at the moment, because I would risk losing my job to talk about it. So I'm stuck in the devil's advocate, you know, where I just need to keep my mouth shut and just get on with it and do my day. And that's
where the hardship lies, guys, you know, that sometimes you have to realise that you're not going to be able to get your dreams all the time. Yeah. That at some point you are, if you're not already there, you're all going to have to settle down and realise, especially when you have a family. Yeah, because you could be one of those guys that'll go out there and not give a shit about your kids and just go off and do what you want to do and thingy, but that's a child, not a man. Yeah. A man will put his own dreams and aspirations on hold to make sure his kids have what they need. That's a man. Yeah. A boy is somebody that just thinks of themselves and gets on with their own life and doesn't care. Yeah, can walk away from their kids. And as long as they're happy, they're happy. Me, I couldn't do that. I have to make sure my kids have what they need. I would love nothing better than to be able to just walk into the life I want to have and feel a lot happier in most things. But it would have a bad effect on my kids. And my kids take top priority to me. They have to. That's the way it is. If you're a man, that's what you do. You put your own aspirations on a bit of a back burner. You don't let go of them. I haven't let go of mine. Yeah. I may not ever reach them, but as long as I'm still striving to get there, I'll still hit better things than what I would do if I just give up on them altogether. You know? That's what sometimes you have to do. You have to realise that sometimes you aren't going to reach those heady heights of the dreams you had, the aspirations you had. But as long as you keep aiming to get there, and as long as you keep trying to get there, or not trying, because trying implores failure. That implies failure to try to do something. You know, that's one of the things I have in life is that I don't like using the word try. Okay? Never use the word try, guys, because try implies failure. Because I'll give you a little thing here to help you out understand this thing. Right? What we're going to do is, okay, if I tell you, okay, I want you to try and pick up this remote control, okay? What would you do? You would probably go out and go, there you go. Well, then you haven't tried to pick it up, have you? You have picked it up. You didn't try to pick it up, you have picked it up. Okay? Now, if you don't touch it at all, then you haven't even tried to pick it up. Okay? So to try and do something is to give it a go, is to make the attempt, is to try with all your might, but to not succeed. Because if you do succeed, then it wasn't a try. You did it. Yeah? Understand that? That makes sense to you? That to try and do something is to fail at it. Is to give it a go, but to fail. Yeah? Because if you did give it a go and you did succeed, you did it. You didn't try to do it, you did it. Okay, guys? Just one little thingy for you. Just one little tidbit in life. And it's thingy. Knock out the word try. If you're doing something, you're not going to try, you're going to do. Yeah, as you would.
No! Try not. Do. Or do not. There is no try.
Okay? So, I will always be making every attempt to be able to get to where I want to be. I may never reach it, but as long as I'm making those attempts, I'm going to get further and higher up that ladder than what I would have done if I just gave up on it altogether and settled where I was. Okay, so you've always got to make those pushes forward. Even if you're at a point in life where you have got a mortgage to pay, you have got wife and kids to feed and clothes and stuff like that, you are going through issues, yeah, because everyone goes through them when they get beyond certain ages. Yeah, even young'uns have issues. They're not major league issues compared to what a lot of the adults have. Some of them may have major league issues. I'm not going to say that they don't. Okay, because that don't get me wrong. I don't want a million and one fucking messages from young'uns telling us their major issues, because I know he's going to have some. Yeah. But what I'm trying to say is, you still push forward. You still work hard to get where you want to be. Because then, even if you don't get there, you're certainly getting further than anybody that quits and doesn't even attempt it. Okay, so always make that attempt to do it. Just realise that sometimes you ain't going to reach the heady heights, but at least you'll be higher up than those that sit on their arse and do nothing and whinge about thingy. Yeah. So keep going at it, guys. Keep trying to live the best you can. Live every day the best you can, because you never know when it's going to end. Okay? You have a timeline in life, a past, a present, and a future. And that timeline is there, and all the things that's in it is there waiting for you to get there. It's just when you'll get there, yeah, including death. You never know when it's going to be, because you can't see that far ahead. Yeah. For anybody, it could be literally today, seconds from now, weeks from now, months from now, years from now. Nobody ever knows when it's going to happen unless you've been given a specific thing. But then it's up to you to still fight that specific thing. If you've, you know, if you have some sort of cancer or something like that, which normally they'll end up saying, oh, you've only got this much time to live and shit, you can still fight that crap. Okay? But what I'm trying to say to you is most people don't know when it's going to happen. You don't know what's in your future. But you've got to keep going until the bitter end, trying to make the best you can of yourself, make the best you can of your life. Try your best, or do your best. I say I've used that word try again. Slip yourself stupid for it. Don't try your best. Do your best to live the best you can. All the time. Thanks very much for watching, guys. Please like, comment, subscribe to watch more of my rants and raves and things that I like to talk about. I'll catch you in the next one, guys. It's the Bearded Wolf, and I'm out. Bad Wolf. The Big Bad Wolf.